Excel reports are not the most exciting thing to talk about, but yeah, I'm talking to you. I've actually been talking to many of our clients or your prospective clients for the last few years about Excel reporting. We think it's such an important topic. It's the number one used business tool in the world, and I'm sure that in your business you'd have Excel all over the place. If you're an IT manager, director, you probably hate this because most IT people I speak to are trying to get rid of Excel. But in finance, Excel is such an integrated tool in any finance department. It's the lifeblood of what happens. So besides the people and the skill that exists there, if they don't have Excel, they struggle to work. And there's some very particular reasons why they use Excel. Number one, all ERP systems are not created equally. So while a lot of the ERP systems have fantastic value and they're great to work with, from importing data, working with the process of finance, being able to make sure that there's accountability across a business when processing any of the financial transactions, where ERP systems really lack is the creativity that finance needs in order to produce valuable insights when they're trying to measure business performance. And that's where reporting comes into play. So a standard P&L, for example, isn't something that's pretty exciting, but when you're taking P&L that needs data from other places, or if you have a group structure and you want to report on the group performance rather than just a single department or entity within that group, ERP systems generally struggle to do that. And when you customize your reports in any way, then Excel is the perfect tool that you know how to use to do that. Now, of course, there are other tools that have been that come across in the last decade or two that challenge Excel. And while Excel will never really be unseated from its position, they serve different purposes. And for that, it's great. I'm speaking to those people who still love and enjoy working with Excel, who feel it's a valuable tool in their business. If you're spending upward of 1 to 3 days a month working in Excel doing manual reporting, there are probably some efficiencies that you can adopt that will help you reduce this time. Things like pivot tables, knowing how to use pivot tables to your advantage, not just simply producing the standard pivot tables that they are, but using the calculation methods to get some of the percentage ratios that are common in finance, using a pivot table that will automatically update as you update your data. Now, of course, you can also do things like have a list of your top 20 items or top 20 customers using a pivot table without having to include a column in your data for ranking and then sorting and then filtering out, you know, the first 20. Pivot tables does this inherently. You can also use pivot tables to do common calculations. For example, if you have a selling price calculation in your data, you have rands and you have units, you know, so for rand times units is selling price. And so that calculation, instead of having that in your table of data, you can now include that in a pivot table. Those are just some quick examples of how pivot tables can be of an advantage to you. There's many more that we can share with you, and if you are interested in learning more, I'd love for you to click on the link and to come join our conversation, see how we've helped customers resolve some of the common challenges that make manual reporting so expensive, but you don't pay attention to it because it's so critical. I'd love to have a conversation with you. Chat to you soon.